स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासितेन्दवः त्रायन्तां वो मधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नखाः. वीर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् प्रतीयमानं पुनरन्यदेव वस्त्वस्ति वाणीषु महाकवीनां यत्तत् प्रसिद्धावयवातिरिक्तं विभाति लावण्यं विवाङ्गनासु. सो टु मीनिङ्ग्स् आर् देर्. वन् इस् द वाच्यार्थ, दि अदर् इस् द प्रतीयमानार्थ. Vachyartha is your primary meaning that you arrive at from reading a shloka or in a kavyam or a sentence, something which gives you the basic meaning. And then from that basic meaning, there is something that is suggested in our minds or in the minds of the reader or the person who listens to that line. So many effects can be. Now, how is this pratiyamanam different from the Vachyartha? That is the context we are at, and he shows us five different types of how the pratimanartha or the suggested meaning is completely different from the vachyartha. We looked at kvachit vachye vidhi rupe pratishedha rupaha vyangyartha or pratimanartha. Then the next one was kvachit vachye pratishedhe vidhi rupaha pratimanartha. And then क्वचित् विधिरूपे वाच्ये सति अनुभयरूपः प्रतीयमानार्थः. अनुभयरूप इन् द सेन्स् इट् इस् नैदर् विधि नार् प्रतिषेध. देर् इस् नो नेगेटिव् यु नो आस्किङ्ग् हिम् नाट् टु डू सम्थिङ्ग् आर् आस्किङ्ग् दि अदर् पर्सन् टु डू सम्थिङ्ग्. देर् इस् नैदर् आफ् देट् एण्ड् इट् इस् जस्ट् द भावम् आर् सम् वस्तु दट् केन् बि रिवील्ड्. सो आल् आफ् दीस् ओके. देन् देन् द फोर्थ् टैप् is vachye pratishedha rupe, where the earlier one was vachye vidhi rupe anubhaya rupaha. Now we have to look at vachye pratishedha rupe anubhaya rupaha pratiyamanah. Kvachit vachye pratishedha rupe anubhaya rupaha yatha prarthaye tavat prasida nivartasva mukha shashi jyotsna vilukta tamo nivahe अभिसारिकाणां विघ्नं करोषि अन्यासामपि हताशे. हे हताशे, अहं प्रार्थये तावत् प्रसीद, यु नो बी प्लीस्ड्, ऐ एम् बेगिङ्ग् यू, निवर्तस्व, गो बेक् आर् डु नाट् डू वाट् यु आर् डूयिङ्ग्. निवर्तस्व, स्वकार्यात् निवर्तस्व. Mukha Shashi Jyotsna, this and Hatashe are an adjective to that Naika. Someone is requesting her. So, hey Hatashe, your hopes are all going to be destroyed. Hatashe, Mukha Shashi Jyotsna Vilukta Tamo Nivahi. Because of your, you know, your face is very beautiful like the moon, Shashi, Shashi Jyotsna, and the rays that come from it is like a Jyotsna. It is like the moon rays. Your face, which is as beautiful and as shining like the moon rays, which can vilupta, which can destroy the tamo nivaham or the darkness that is present. Because of that, because your face is so prakasha yuktam, abhisarikanam vignam karoshi. You are creating an obstacle for the abhisarikastri. I will have to read the lochanam in this. Because it's the different things that he gives in the lochanam is very beautiful. So we will go through the vyakhyanam for this. Atra vyavasitat gamanat nivartasva iti pratitehe nishedhaha vachyaha. We are looking at vachyartha, which is a pratishedha rupa. What is the negative aspect? Don't do something or stop doing whatever you're doing. Vyavasitat gamanat, the Naika is planning to leave now. She is either to go to her Nayaka's house or she is trying to leave, something like that. So we will look at the context also. He is going to explain in the lochana. So vyavasitat gamanat nivartasva, stop from your action or stop from going. That is your pratishedha rupah, nishedaha vachyah. Griha agata naika, a naika has come to the house, and gotra skhalanadi aparadhini nayake sati. Then the beloved has mentioned somebody else's name, some other naika's name. So gotra skhalanam is mentioning somebody else's name. So that is an aparadha. Tadrisha aparadhini nayake sati. When that nayaka has made such a mistake, tataha pratigantum pravritta nayika. Tataha grihat. She wants to return. Nayakena. Now the nayaka has to appease her. So chatu upakramapurvakam nivartyate. He uses chatuvakyam. He uses very clever words and he tries to stop her. Nivartyate. Na kevalam sva atmanaha mama cha nirvriti vignam karoshi. Tavat anyasam api. Here, by returning, you're not only stop being an obstacle, or you're not only foregoing your happiness, you're also making me miserable by going away. So you've come here to be with me, to enjoy with me. By returning, because I made a small mistake of mentioning somebody else's name, you're by going away, you're not only stopping your happiness, you're also putting a stop to my happiness. We cannot be together. So, na kevalam swatmanaha nirvriti vignam, nirvriti sukha. Swatmanaha sukhasya vignam, vignamatram na karoshi, apitu mamavi sukhasya vignam karoshi. Tavat anyasam api, anyasam abhisarikanam. Tava prakasha karanat. So, abhisarikas usually move during the night when there is darkness. And if you go now, your face is so bright that the others will feel that there is another moon here and they won't be able to do whatever they want. Tarhi abhisarikanam api vighnam karoshi yatra. Tavat anyasam api tataha tava na kadachana sukha lava labaha api bhavishyati ityatayeva hatasha asi. So your hopes are all destroyed. Hence, there is not even a little bit of sukham for you in this action. So do not do that. Iti vallabha abhipraya rupaha chatu visheshaha vyangyaha atra. So we understand how cleverly that Nayaka or that Priya is trying to convey his abhiprayam, that he wants to be with her. So in a very chatu is in a very clever manner. That is one way of looking at it. The other thing that he says is yadiva, or it need not be a nayakasya upadesha, nayakasya vakyam, kintu sakhyaha upadeshyam. So, yadiva sakhya upadeshyamana api tad avadhiranaya gacchanti sakhya uchyate. Sakhi vadati atra. What does she say? Say, I keep trying to tell you that man, no, don't go to him. Your hopes will be destroyed. Don't go there. Iti punah punah sakhya upadeshyamana api tad avadhiranaya. Sakhim na shrunoti esha gacchanti sakhya uchyate. So at that, even ignoring her advice, she goes and that sakhi again tells her, na kevalam atmanaha vighnam karoshi laghavat abahumana aspadam atmanam kurvati. You are putting yourself in a disrespectful position by going and seeing him. Atayeva hatasha. You should not approach him, he should be approaching you. So that is a sakhi's words. Let him come to you. You know, he has made a mistake. Let him come to you. Why are you lowering yourself and going? Do not give up your self-esteem. So laghavat abahumana aspadam atmanam kuruvati atayeva hatasha. Yavat vadana chandrika prakashita margataya. The same meaning. That part is very, the same words. So here you can only say it is sakhyaha chatuvakyam. So yavat vadana chandrika prakashita margataya anyasamapi abhisarikanam vignam karoshi iti sakhi abhipraya rupaha chatu visheshaha vyangyaha. But in this, both of these vyakhyanam, Abhinav Gupta is not satisfied with this because he feels it is not a dvani kavyam, it is a guni bhuta vyangyam or a madhyama kavyam. This is atra priyatama chatuvakyam athava sakhyaha chatuvakyam ityeva vachyasya pradhanyam bhavati. Tasmat vyangyasya tu na pradhanyam atra preyaha iti rasavad alankaraha bhavati natu dhvanihi. That's his contention. So he gives another method of saying that. So tena ayam atra bhavaha. This third one is what Abhinav Gupta's. Yeah, tell me.
So how can we understand that the Sakhi is saying these words, Akka, that I'm not clear?
Okay, so Sakhi is trying to stop her from going to meet the Nayaka.
Yeah, but
Then,
in the first thing that we saw, you said it's the it is the words of the Nayaka who's talking to his beloved, right?
correct. So, how that context will apply? See, the words are just Prarthaye, I beg you, do not go. You are going to cause a vighnam to other abhisarikas.
Okay.
That is all the shloka says. So we
Yeah.
are trying to fit that in a context. So in the first context, imagine a Nayika has come to the Nayaka's house, beloved's house. She is there. The moment she enters, he calls her and calls her by somebody else's name.
Oh, okay.
So she gets angry and she wants to go back. So the Nayaka tries to console her and says, no, I meant this name. It could be another name. Don't go because of this. You're only spoiling the nice opportunity that the both of us have.
Okay.
Don't do that. That is one way of looking at it. The other context is the Nayaka has not been showing much of an attention to the Nayika. So she wants to go and find out what the whole thing is and be with him. The Sakhi is trying to dissuade her from that. She says,
Oh,
don't go.
okay.
You are only going to put yourself in a position of disrespect. Don't do that. And at the same time, you will also cause a vighnam to the other abhisarikas. That is just a matter of fact. It is just a nicer way of putting it instead of saying, don't put yourself in a disrespectful position.
Oh,
You
okay.
are going to get humiliated. Don't go there. Instead of saying it directly, she is begging her and saying, Prarthaye, tavat prasida, don't go, nivartasva, gamanat, nivartasva. Kimartham, what is the reason she gives? She gives a very clever reason by saying, if you go out, your face is so bright, you're looking like a moon, you're going to cause vighnam for others. That is
Oh.
not here.
Oh. So in the first scenario, if we think that the Nayaka is talking to to his beloved, how would Hatasha fit there? I mean, she does it from the shloka. It is not clear that she has an Asha to meet him. She wants to leave, right? So how does Hatasha fit there in the
No,
second one?
you came with an Asha and you are destroying it by trying to get out.
Oh.
She approached him only with the idea to meet him, right?
Oh, okay.
That is why he says Hatasha. So
Okay.
you are losing out on that opportunity.
Okay.
That's it.
Thank you.
So the third one is Rasamayam. So here he says, Tena ayam atra bhavah kachit rabhasat प्रियतमम् अभिसरन्ति तद्गृह अभिमुखम् आगच्छता तेनैव हृदयवल्लभेन एवम् उपश्लोक्यते अप्रत्यभिज्ञानच्छलेन. He is in his house. She is coming to meet him. And the Vallabha, knowing just beforehand, she is almost in front of the house, But he feels that she will be caught by the Sapatni or his wife, maybe. This is a lover. So he is trying to stop her from coming inside the house. Don't come inside. Don't go inside. You come with me. Either let's go somewhere else. So he says, Tadgriha Abhimukham Agachata. No. I think. मदीयं वा गृहम् आगच्छ त्वदीयं वा गृहं गच्छ इति उभयत्रापि तात्पर्यात् अनुभयरूपः. That's very interesting. I'm trying to think what he said. So she wants to go. Okay. So काचित् रभसात् प्रियतमम् अभिसरन्ति. She wants to go and meet her beloved. तद्गृह अभिमुखम् आगच्छता तेनैव हृदयवल्लभेन उपश्लोक्यते शी इज बीइंग प्रेस्ड एंड ही सेज अप्रत्यभिज्ञान छलेन ओके वन मिनट आई डोंट नो दिस सिचुएशन इज सो समटाइम्स इट्स सो आउट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्स्ट बट ही वांट्स टू शो दैट दिस इज अ ध्वनि श्लोक एंड नॉट अ गुणीभूत व्यंग्यम Maybe it's too beyond the level, but it's okay. I'll just, because I've started, I will explain it. So Kachit Rabasat, one Naika is going to meet her Priyatama. And at that point of time, while she is going towards his house, the Vallabha meets her. The Priya, beloved, comes and meets her on the way itself. And she pretends as if she doesn't recognize him. Apratya Vijnana Chalena. She pretends as if she has not recognized him. And Atma Pratya Vijnapanartham, he wants to say that, no, I am the same person. So do not go outside. Either let's go to your house or let's go to my house. So it can be either way. Do not go far quickly. Do not ignore me and go. That's what he is trying to say. Anyasam cha vignam karoshi. Tavacha ipsita labhaha bhavishyati iti ka pratyasha. See, you are going to cause obstacle to others. That part is very clear. It is the same in all three versions. Here, you are also not going to be satisfied if you ignore me and go, because I am your Priya and I am here at this point. Atayeva madiyam griham agacha. So come to my house. Or Twadiyamba Gacha, or let's go to your house. Let's not meet at a common place, or let's not meet at a Sanketa Sthanam. So it shows his Shringaram in a more intensified manner than anything. So Tatparyat Anubhaya Rupaha. So we don't know what he wants to convey. It can either be Madiyam Griham Agacha, Atava Twadiyam Griham Gacha. So the Pratisheda. End result is the pratisheda vachya pratisheda rupe pratiyamanam tu anubhaya rupam. It is neither pratishedam nor is it a vidhi rupam. Okay, so anyetu tatasthanam sahridayanam abhisarikam prati yamuktihi. So one abhisarika is just going, some stand by, you know, there is a person who is just standing. There are some sahridaya, some connoisseurs who just like this girl. They are standing in the street and they are commenting, you know, don't go. You are going to cause an obstacle to the other Abhisarikas. So they are saying, you know, just be here, give us some pleasure, or come with me to my house. It can be either way. So it can be a neutral people who are standing in the road talking to a lady, beautiful lady who is walking to meet her beloved. So tatra hatashe iti amantranadi yuktam ayuktam va. Iti sahridaya eva pramanam. Here, sahridaya eva pramanam is something that you have to keep in mind, where it is only the sahridaya who can say what is there in their mind and whichever is appealing to them, to their mind. It is the samskara vishesha that is there in their mind which makes them understand so many different suggestions from one shloka. So sahridaya eva pramanam. Vachye pratishedha rupe anubhaya rupaha. The next one is even more beautiful. That is, kvachit vachyat vibhinna vishayatvena vyavasthapitaha yata. Kasyavana bhavati rosho drishtva priyayaha sabrana madharam sabhramara padma grana shile varitavame sahaswa idani. Naika has gone and met her Kamuka. She's been with him and they have kissed each other. Her lips are a little bit sore. Now, she comes back home and her pati is waiting there. That pati is Roshaha. So he can be very short-tempered here. And Kasyavana Bhavati Rosho. Even a jealous person, a person who is not jealous, will become jealous by looking at this. And this is her, you know, she has probably pledged her life to this man. And so he says, you know, this is the ukti of a sakhi who is trying to protect her from the angry husband. So kasyava na bhavati roshaha. Who will not be angry after seeing her, his beloved's lips, which is savranam, which is wounded. So savranam adharam priyayaha savranam adharam drushtva kasya roshaha na bhavati. Now, this is where the protection of that sakhi comes in. She says, Sabhramara Padma Agrana Shile Varitavame Sahasvai Danim. Sabhramara. you have this chilam, you have this character of constantly taking lotuses which have bees and trying to smell that. So what will happen? As a result, the lotus is so beautiful, you want to smell it, so you take the lotus and you constantly keep doing this, not once but twice but many times. So which means that bee that is there inside that lotus wants to has come and stung you so many times. Varita vame, I have already tried to stop you many times. Varita vama, vama is beautiful lady. You have been stopped by me many times, and yet you insist on making your lips wounded. I can't help you after this. I have protected you this time. Sahasvaidani. The literal meaning, vachyartha, is just who will not become angry after seeing his beloved's wounded lips. Oh lady, who is, you know, you are you have this character of constantly smelling lotuses, trying to take in the fragrance of a lotus which has bees. I have tried to stop you many times. Now you have to tolerate this. Sahasvaidani. The idea, different people get different ideas in their mind. Anishyaloho api bhavati roshaha drushtva eva akritvapi kutaschideva apurvataya priyayaha sabranam adharam avalokya. Now this pati is not the cause for the sabranam adharam. She has may wounded gotten wounded lips from something else. So, a person who normally doesn't get jealous also will become very angry after seeing this. That is your context. Sa bhramara padma aghrana shile, shilam hi kathanchidapi varayetum na shakyam. Shilam means character. It is something that is inborn. You want to be with that, you know, the kamuka. You don't, you are repeatedly, even after I try to stop you keep going and meeting him. I can't help you after this. So she says, Varayit Kathanchit Shilam Ityukti Kathanchidapi Varayitum Nashakyam. Whatever I tell you're going to keep on doing it again and again. Varite Varanayam Vame Anangikarini. That is another meaning. So Varita Api Vame Vame Ityukte Anangikarini. Vama means crooked. See, even when I try to stop you, you give me all sorts of reasoning and justify, and you don't accept any reason that I tell you to not do this, to not keep on going and meeting your kamuka. Sahasvaidani. Iti upalamba parampara. She's actually, you know, scolding her by saying, you know, you have to tolerate this. I can't help you. That's the way the sakhi is saying this. Atra ayam bhavaha. Kachit Avinita, an indisciplined girl, kutaschit, from somewhere, khandita adara, her lips have been injured. So nischita tat savidha sannidhane tad bhartari. Before, you know, he is suspecting some wrong play here. The pati is suspecting something here. Nischitam, tat savidha, kamuka savidham. तत् सन्निधाने तद्भर्तरी च अविनीतायाः भर्तरी सन्निधाने सति. When he is near there and he is within you know, hearing range, she is saying, तम् अनवलोकमानया इव कयाचित् विदग्ध सख्या. As if she has not noticed the pati, the sakhi. Sakhi, she is behaving as if she has not seen that pati, and she is generally warning. So if the pati gets wind of the fact that the sakhi knows he is present, then he will know that there is some problem and he will be suspicious. She is acting as if she has not seen that pati. She is just looking at the girl who is coming now after meeting that kamuka. So imagine that kamuka is also somewhere. He is waiting, he has followed her, and he's just waiting there to see if she is safe and her husband is there or not. She is gone, she's been there with him for some time, and she is late in coming. Her husband has arrived already. This sakhi, she's behaving as if she's not seen that husband, and she is only scolding this lady. So that the pati will not have any suspicion about this. Okay? So much of scene you have to imagine here. सो कयाचित् विदग्ध सख्या तम अनवलोकमानया इव एज इफ शी इज नॉट सीन द पति कयाचित् विदग्ध सख्या वेरी क्लेवर सखी तद्वाच्यता परिहाराय तद्वाच्यता भर्तृ वाच्यता वाच्यता निंदा सो भर्तृ कोप परिहाराय एवं उच्यते सहस्व इदानीं इति वाच्यम् अविनयवती विषयम् सो यू हैव टू टेक दिस नो भर्तृ विषयम् सहस्व इदानीं इत्युक्ते नो यू हैव टू बेर द वूंड वन थिंग और यू हैव टू if you insist on going and meeting him in a secret manner you have to face the consequences that is the vyangyartha that is there in the mind of the nayika bhartru vishayam tu aparadaha nasti iti avedyamanam vyangyam no she's actually not made any mistake it is she loves to We're taking the fragrance of a lotus and so she has just suffered like this. That is the vyangyartham for the bharta, the pati. Sahasva ityapi cha tad vishayam vyangyam. Now when she says sahasva, she's saying, you know, give some consideration to her, tolerate her behavior like this. You know, she wants to constantly keep smelling that lotus. So please tolerate that attitude in her. That is a bhartra vishayam vyangyam. Tasyam cha प्रियतमेन गाढम् उपलभ्यमानायां तद्व्यलीकशङ्कितप्रातिवेशिकलोकविषयं च अविनयप्रच्छादनेन प्रत्यायनं व्यङ्ग्यम् सो तस्यां च प्रियतमेन गाढम् उपलभ्यमानायां शी मे बी अ टार्गेट् आफ् एङ्गर् एण्ड् दट् नायिका कुड् बी एन् टार्गेट् आफ् एङ्गर् तद्व्यलीकशङ्कितप्रातिवेशिक लोकविषयं च अविनयप्रच्छादनेन प्रत्यायनम् ऐ एम् ट्रैङ्ग् टु कवर् युर् अविनयत्वं सो व्यलीकशङ्कितं यु आर् अन्नेसेसरिलि डौटिङ्ग् हर् सो डोण्ट् डौट् हर् इन् केस् इफ् द नो इफ् शी इफ् द पति हेज़् सम् लिटिल् बिट् आफ् सस्पिशन् आल्सो डोण्ट् I'm trying to cover that. That is what is being revealed here. Tad sapatnyam cha, tad upalambha, tad avinaya prahrishtayam. See, he says, what is that? Apriyayaha savranam adharam. The word priya, in case that pati has other wives also. So the other wives would now find this as an opportunity, you know, to... we can get her out of the house or she has constantly been in his favor she has been the favorite of the pati and this can be an opportunity she has cheated on him and he will lose interest in her we can use this so in case the sapatni or the co-wives are thinking of such an attitude or thinking of doing something like this then the sakhi has shut their mouth also in the sense she's saying priya she's still his favorite and I have protected her so tat sapatnyam tu in the minds of that co-wives tad upalamba tad avinaya prahrishtayam he is going to the pati is going to scold her and then she is going to be humiliated in that and so the sapatni is very happy about it saubhagya atishayakyapanam no she is very fortunate this nayika is extremely fortunate So you don't need to feel very happy about the fact that she is going to be humiliated or she is going to be scolded by her pati. Iti priyayaha iti shabda balat sapatni vishayam vyangyam. Sapatni madhye yata khali krita asmi iti laghavam atmani grahitum na yuktam pratyuta ayam bahumanaha. Now again in the to the nayika Another vyangyam, what it means is, see, in front of your sapatni, I have protected you. This, in fact, is a bahumanam. Even though you are a bad person, your pati thinks of you as such a favorite person that it is actually a respect that he will accept you despite all this. So, sapatni madhye iyata khali krita asmi iti laghavam atmani grahitum na yuktam. Don't feel humiliated about the fact that you have been shown in such a bad light in front of the sapatni. Don't be like that. प्रत्युत बहुमानः सहस्व न ओन् इट् शोभस्व इति उक्तिः शोभस्व इदानीम् इति सखी विषयं सौभाग्यप्रख्यानं व्यङ्ग्यम् अद्य इयं तव प्रच्छन्न अनुरागिणी हृदयवल्लभा इत्थं रक्षिता नौ सन्निधाने कामुकः प्रायः विद्येत If he is present, if the other, you know, the second guy, the Upanayaka is present here, then this is a Sakhi's way of telling that Kamukam, you know, today I have saved both of you. Next time, make sure that you don't show such outward signs of the way you have been together, of your union. Punaha. Again, prakata radana damsha vidihi na videyaha. You should not behave in such a manner that you show off the hurt in her lips. So, the chaurya kamuka vishaya sambodhanam vyangyam. This is for the secret lover. That is the vyangyam that comes for him. Itham, now what do we understand from all of this? Wow, she's so clever. इत्थं मया एतद् अपन्नुतम् इति स्ववैदग्ध्यख्यापनम् She reveals her cleverness to तटस्थ विदग्ध लोक विषयम् If there is an audience present in this entire scene, then she has told everybody that, see, I'm such a clever person, be careful. That is also revealed. So what do you say about, can you even deny the fact that Pratiyamanartha is present? Each one can understand different things from just this one shloka. More than Anandavardhana, it is Abhinav Gupta's imagination is what, you know, the way he, imagination, his sagradayatvam is what I'm amazed with. Kasyavana bhavati rosho drishtva priyayaha sabranam adharam. So now let's move to Anyecha evam prakaraha vachyat vibhedinaha pratiyamana bhedaha sambhavanti. So other things also can see, we have only talked about how pratiyamanam suggestion can be completely duram vibhedinaha, is completely different from what is the vachyartha. It can be opposite to what the vachyartha is. It can be anubhaya rupa or vibhinna vishayatvena vyavasthapitaha. It can be established where just like gatoastha markaha. This is very similar to gatoastha markaha. The sun is set can give rise to different meanings in different people. You can do a write a shloka in that manner. So anyecha evam prakaraha, in the same manner there can be other types also, pratiyamana bhedaha, many divisions of pratiyamanartha or suggestions which can occur, which are completely different vibhedinaha from vachyat tesham ding matram etat pradarshitam. This is just a small aspect that I have shown you. This entire thing is called vastudvani. None of this is either alankara or rasa that is suggested, but it is a vastu or some vishaya, something is, some subject matter has been suggested here in each and every of this shloka, the five shlokas that we have seen before. This is one type of dhvani, one division of dhvani. The second division is alankara dhvani. Dvitiyaha द्वितीयोपि प्रभेदः वाच्यात् विभिन्नः सप्रपञ्चम् अग्रे दर्शयिष्यते. इवन् द सेकेण्ड् केटगरि विच् इस् द अलङ्कारध्वनि दट् विल् बि शोन् इन् द द्वितीय उद्योते विस्तरेण. वि विल् लुक् एट् इट् इन् द द्वितीय उद्योत बिकास् गिविङ्ग् एक्साम्पल्स् हियर् द मेन् पायिण्ट् आफ् युर् फस्ट् उद्योतम् इस् नाट् टु गिव् द डेफिनेशन्स् आफ् आल् द डिविजन्स् आफ् आल् द ध्वनि इमीडियेट्लि. So he first has to establish, he showed the misconceptions. He has to prove that each and every misconception does not hold good. So that is his bhumika. So that will be covered in the first Udyotam. In the second Udyotam, he will go to the divisions and talk about Alankaradhvani and Rasadhvani in detail in the second Udyotam. Now the third one, Tritiyastu, he has a small discussion in this section. सो तृतीयस्तु रसादिलक्षणः प्रभेदः वाच्यसामर्थ्याक्षिप्तः प्रकाशते न तु साक्षात् शब्दव्यापारविषयः इति वाच्यात् विभिन्नः एव. द फस्ट् वेरैटि वास् वस्तुध्वनि, द सेकेण्ड् वेरैटि वास् अलङ्कारध्वनि, द थर्ड् वेरैटि इस् रसध्वनिः. दिस् थर्ड् वेरैटि आल्सो रसादिलक्षणः ध्वनिः अपि प्रभेदः अपि वाच्यसामर्थ्य आक्षिप्तः आक्षिप्तः प्रतीयते प्रकाशते आक्षिप्तः सन् प्रतीयते आर् प्रकाशते ओन्लि बै द फोर्स् आफ् युर् वाच्यार्थं द रसध्वनि इस् अण्डर्स्टुड् इस् नोन्. Vachya means the artha, the meaning that comes out, the, by the primary meaning, I also understand the suggested meaning. Without the primary meaning, the suggested meaning cannot exist. You will in fact say, alokarthi deepashikeva. If you want rasadhvani in your kavyam, you have to put in the right words and the right meaning, like auchityam. It should be there. You have to look for the proper words and meaning. So, Vachyartha is extremely important. And Vachya Samarthyat Akshiptaha Rasadihi, based on the Vachyartha, based on the primary meaning, the suggested Rasadihi Prakashate, it shines forth. Nato sakshat shabda vyapara vishayaha. Sakshat shabda swashabda niveditam. If I just say nayakasya shungara rasaha pratiyate atra, that will not give us that rasa aswadanam. If I mention the word shringara, it is not going to give me rasa aswadanam. Tathahi vachyatvam tasya swashabda niveditatvena vasyat vibhavadi pratipadana mukhena va. There are two pakshas here. What are the two things he is saying? Tasya vachyatvam rasadehe pratitihi vachyatvam and pratitihi, understanding of that rasa or the rasa aswadanam tu katham bhavati swashabda niveditatvena athava vibhavadi pratipadana mukhena iti prashnaha vidyate atra. So what is swashabda niveditatvam? Shringaradi shabdaihi eva nivedita means abhidhava dvara bodhanam. Abhidha is the vyaparam with which we understand, the process with which we understand the primary meaning. Do we understand Shringara, etc. by the primary meaning of the word Shringara itself? Or is it because Vibhava, Anubhava, Vyabhichari, and then you get the Sthayi Bhava? By the mixture of Vibhava, Anubhava and Vyabhichari Bhava, we have the Sthayi Bhava, which attains the status of a rasam, which is the process with which rasa is understood. These are the two paksha. Purvasmin pakshe. So here, before we start the next line, we have to understand what is... Chule.
Idhikku munnadi dana, ivar vandu enak purilada. The tathahi vachyatvam appdin solittu vibhavadi pratipadanam, sorry natu sakshat shabda vyapara vishayahan solittar liya
solittar. So why
edhik therapy kelvi kelpan
kelvi kekrana? See what he says is vachyat vibhinna eva sakshat shabda vyapara vishayah na asti. He has to prove it. No, if sakshat shabda vyaparah nasti chet katham bhavati விபாவாதி சப்தேன விபாவாதி பிரதிபாதன முக்கேன.
ஓகே, சோ சும்மா ஒரு பூர்வ பக்ஷத்துக்காக அந்த சப்த நிவேதிதத்வேன வாஸ்யாத்
ஒரு ஒரு பிரிமைஸ் மாதிரி எடுத்துக்கிறாருமா? தி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டேட்மென்ட் இஸ் லைக் எ பிரிமைஸ். சரி, வை டு யூ ஹேவ் டு ஈவன் ஸ்டார்ட் ஆஃப் வித் சாட்சாத் சப்த வியாபாரித விஷயா ந இதி, எதுக்கு நீ வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் எழுதணும் அப்படின்னா, நோ தேர் எக்ஸிஸ்ட் டூ பாசிபிலிட்டிஸ். One is Svashabdanivedi Tattvam, the other is Vibhavadi Pratipadana Mukham. In these two possibilities, I'm clearly stating that Svashabdanivedi Tattvam cannot happen because of the following reasons. Nutu, the paragraph starts. See, the method of Dhanyaloka writing, it will take some time for you to understand how he arranges the text. Yeah, we are talking about this. It's like how we have a conversation. Why do you mean it is not something where he says this is how it is, these are the divisions, this is the lakshanam, this is the lakshyam. That's not how it goes. It is not like Kavya Prakash. So even the language is very different. Just like how the language of Kalidasa is different from Bhavabhuti to Shudraka, Mrichakatikam. The language itself is very, the way he presents his arguments are also very different. So he starts off by saying, Tritiyastu rasadi lakshanaha prabhedaha vachya samarthyakshiptaha prakashyate. Vachya ityukte shungara iti shabda rupenava. Abdina kelvi varlam. Adukaha he says, natu sakshat shabda vyaparaha. Sakshat shabda vyaparaha anavidyate chet katham rasadehe pratitihi bhavati. Vibhavadi pratipadana mukhena uta swashabda niveditatvena. Then he sets forth his argument. Okay. Before we start off with that, he actually talks of Anvaya and Vyatireka. We have to understand what is Anvaya Vyapti and what is Vyatireka Vyapti. Anvaya Vyaptihi is Tatsatve Tatsatvam, Vyatireka Vyapti Tadabhave Tadabhavaha. Like how Yatra Dhumaha Tatra Vannihi, Yatra Vanyabhavaha Tatra Dhumasya Abhavaha Api Vidyate. If we can find a relationship between two objects in this manner, where I say the presence of one invariably gives me the presence of the other, or the absence of one can prove the absence of the other, or can show me the absence of the other. That is called the relation between, in a positive manner is Anvaya, and the relation in a negative manner is the Vyatireka. When you show the relation between the absence, it is Vyatireka. When you show the relation between the presence of an object, then it is Anvaya Vyapti. So, Tatsatve, Tatsatvam, Tadabhave, Tadabhavaha. That is your main thing. So, have that in mind. And he uses this concept to explain how Swashabda Niveditatve, Rasadi Pratitihi na Vidyate, Kintu Vibhavadi Pratipadana Mukhena iva Rasadi Pratitihi Bhavati. Purvasmin pakshe, what is the first paksham? Which is Swashabda Niveditattvam. Purvasmin pakshe, Swashabda Niveditattva abhave rasadinam apratitihi prasangaha. Apratiti prasangaha. If I say that rasadi, rasa, etc. is known through its own word, then yatra Swashabda Niveditattvam nasti, tatra rasadinam apratitihi bhavishyati. If the word shringara is not mentioned, then I will not be able to understand shringara at all. I should not enjoy shringara if the word shringara is not present. But that is not the case. Na cha sarvatra tesham swashabda niveditattvam asti. Na cha sarvatra tesham swashabda niveditattvam. Not everywhere in a shloka, when we look at Shringara Rasam, it's not in Kasyavana Bhavati Rosho or in the shloka for Brahmadharmika Vishrabda, Sashamaka Adhya Maritasthena. Where is Shringara mentioned there? But we understand that she wants to, you know, stop him there. But that is not an example of Rasadhvani. Just giving you, just to say that. So, Swashabda Nivedi Tattvam, or we can take the, what is that shlokam? Vyaparayamasa vilochanani adilla adenna twamalikya pranayakupitam dhaturagai shilayam. So in Megha Sandesham there is a shloka where it's a Vipralamba Shringara dhvani, where the yaksha is trying to draw the picture of his beloved, his wife, on a shilayam. The twamalikya Pranaya Kupitam, you are very angry with me during the love quarrel, and I am drawing your picture in that manner. Twamalikya Pranaya Kupitam Dhaturagai Shilayam, and I want to draw myself falling at your feet, you know, trying to appease you. So as I try to draw that, by just looking at your face, I start crying. You know, he is separated from her. And the moment he looks at that face that he himself has drawn in the picture, he starts crying and his eyes are clouded with the tears, and he is not able to look clearly to draw himself there. So he says, Kruras tasminnapi na sahate sangamam nau kritanta. This Yama is so, you know, cruel. that he cannot tolerate the union between us even in a picture. He doesn't want us to be together even in the picture. Kruras tasmin napi na sahate, tasmin ityukte chitre. Chitre api asmakam sangamaha na sahate. Here, he doesn't mention irshya, vipralamba, shringara or any such thing. So, even then, we understand, we feel that vipralamba rasa. So, nacha sarvatra kavye, rasamaye kavye, tesham rasadinam, swashabda niveditattvam asti. Yatra pyasti tat, yatra kavye tat, swashabda niveditattvam asti. Even if there is a mention of that rasa, eko rasa karuna eva. In Uttara Ramacharitam, he mentions karuna rasa. He mentions the word rati. He's very... Ananda Vardhana actually, Abhinav Gupta has a gripe with Bhavabhuti by saying that swashabda niveditattvam asti tatra. So it is not a rasamayam kavya. But the Natakam is in such a manner that even if Bhavabhuti mentions Karuna there, it doesn't matter. We still feel for that. Yatrapi swashabda niveditattvam asti tatrapi kavye vishishta vibhavadi pratipadana mukhenaiva esham pratitihi vibhavasya avashyakata vartate anubhavanam avashyakata. Vyabhichari bhavanam cha avashyakata vartate. It need not be mentioned there directly, but we should be able to understand that vyabhichari bhava. If you have studied Kavya Prakasham 4th chapter, this will be easier to understand. This line is very easy to understand. You know why? There he will actually mention, if vibhava alone is present, I can understand shringaram. If just vibhava and anubhava is present, or only anubhava is present there, and who is the naika, who is the nayaka, the description of them, the beauty of them is not mentioned in a shloka also, and with just the anubhava, we can understand shringara rasa. Just the vyabhichari bhava, everything else can be suggested by just the anubhava or just the vyabhichari bhava. That itself is enough for me to understand the rasa. Rasa aswadanaya kevala vibhavasyabhi avashyakata vartate. One of them should at least have been mentioned in that shlokam or suggested in that shlokam without direct word. Okay. So tatrapi kavye vishishta mithaha samsargena atishayitanam vibhavadinam pratipadana mukhenaiva esham rasadinam pratitihi vidyate. Swashabdena sa kevalam anudyate. Swashabdena sa rasadi pratitihi. Anudyate means it is just a reiteration of it. See, the rasam has already been enjoyed. It is being enjoyed, or it is being rasaha aswadyate. Swashabdaha is just a catalyst there. That's all. It just is a repetition there. Even without it, I can understand. Natu tatkrita swashabdena utpadita rasadi pratitihi na. So it is not produced by that word shringaram. Vishayantare vibhavadi abhavasthale tu rasadehe adarshanat, tasyaha adarshanat, rasapratitehe adarshanat. Rasadishe shabdaha kevalam, swashabdena rasadi pratitihi kevalam anudyate, taihi shabdaihi rasa aswadanam na utpadyate, na tatkrita, na swashabdaihi krita utpadita rasapratitihi. Vishayantare tu yatra vibhavadi abhavaha vidyate tatra rasasyapi pratitihi na bhavati. Understand? Nahi kevala shringaradi shabda matra bhaji vibhavadi pratipadana rihite kavye managapi rasavatva pratitihi asti. Kevala shringaradi shabda matra bhaji kavye. In a kavyam which has just the words shringara, vibhavadi pratipadana rahite kavye, he is just explaining. See, when he said the line Vishayantare Tatha Tasyaha Adarshanat, he is explaining that statement in this paragraph. Kevala Shungara Adi Shabda Matra Vaji, just the word Shungara is present. Vibhavadi Pratipadana Rahite, the suggestion or the description of Vibhava, Anubhava and Vibhichari Bhava is absent in that Kavyam. Rasavatta Pratitihi Manakapi Na Asti. I cannot understand that Rasavattvam, that this Kavyam has a rasa. It has that sentiment. I cannot understand it. Pratitihi Na Vidyate. Yatascha Swa Abhidanam Antarena Kevalebhyaha Api Vibhavadibhyaha Vishishtebhyaha Rasadinam Pratitihi. Swa Abhidanam Antarena Vibhava Anubhava Vyabhichari Bhava Iti Bhavanam Abhidanam Antarena Bhavadi Shabdanam Vina Shabda Shabdaihi Vina Api Shabdan Vina Api Tesham Pratitihi Bhavati Tebhyaha Vibhavadibhyaha Vishishtebhyaha Rasadinam Pratitihi Bhavati. I don't need to have Chinta there. In when Malavika tries to, you know, talk about her feelings through a dance, she is displaying her dance in front of Agnimitra, and Malavika is saying the shloka Durlabha Priyaha. It's very difficult to attain that Priya, but he is now in front of me. Now, what do I say? How do I approach him? All I can say is, you know, accept me. I surrender to you. That is the words of those shloka. Where is that shloka? Durlabha Priyaha. Durlabha Priyome Tasminna Bhava Hridaya Nirasham. Aho Apangaha Me Praspurati Kimapi Vamakaha. So she's saying, my left eye is throbbing, so maybe I'm going to see him. It's a harsha. In first, she says, it's very difficult to see my beloved. Suddenly, she displays that her left eye is throbbing. Vamakaha spurati. Maybe I'm going to see him. It is like a nice omen. It's a good omen. Esha sat chiradrishtaha katham upanetavyaha. Now I am seeing him in front of me after a long time. Esha saha chiradrishtaha katham upanetavyaha. How do I approach him? Natha mam paradina twai ganaya sav krishna. I'm actually dependent on somebody else. But you know, I understand that I am with, you know, I desire you. Satrishnam iti mam smara. Now here, nowhere is she mentioning the bhava harsha, nor is there a description of Malavika. There is no description of Agnimitra. And we don't have the words of harsha, chinta, or any of those vyavichari bhavas which will lead to shungara rasam. Yet, the moment you hear these words, and if you also imagine Malavika dancing for these words, you will enjoy that rasam that she is able to portray through that dance. Right? So the kevalebhyaha vibhavadibhyaha vishishtebhyaha vishishtebhyaha vishesha rupena sambalitebhyaha eva vibhavadibhyaha from those vibhava etc. Sva abhidanam antarena, those words are not mentioned. Rasadinam pratitihi bhavati. Kevalat cha sva abhidanat apratitihi. If just the words are mentioned, but there is no chamatkara vishayam there, then the rasa pratitihi na vidyate. Tasmat anvaya vyatireka abhyam. So what is the anvaya vyapti and the vyatireka vyapti? You say tatsatve tatsatvam. Yatra vishishta vibhavadayaha santi tatra rasa aswadanam vidyate. Vyatireka vyapti tadabhave tadabhavaha. Yatra vibhavadi pratipadanam na vidyate tatra rasavattva pratitihi nasti. Iti anvaya vyatireka mukhena vyatireka abhyam abideya samarthya akshiptatvam eva rasadinam abideya. Abideya samarthya abideyam, that which has to be said. It is only by the force of what which has to be said is being said, and from that we understand the rasa. Rasadinam akshiptattvam. Natu abideyatvam kathanchit. Kathanchit, somehow I say, you know, whether the vibhava anubhava is there or not. If the word shrungara is present, then I understand. Such a situation can never exist. So, nad abideyatvam kathanchit iti na kadachit bhavitum arhati prasadina. Iti tritiyaha api prabedaha vachyat bhinna eva iti sthitam. Even the third rasadvani is also, we can say that it is completely different from the vachya, from the word. But it depends on the vachyatvam. It depends. Vachyena tu asya saha iva pratitihi iti agre darshayishyate. See, it's along with the vachyartha, along with the primary meaning. We understand the rasam. Without the primary meaning, without durlabhav priyoha, tasmin hatasha nirasham bhava, bhava hriteya nirasha. You know, without those words, without that primary meaning, there is nothing. I can only say, you know, just think and you will understand. It won't happen like that. You need the primary word, you need the primary meaning, then you understand the rasam. Tataha eva rasa pratitihi bhavati. Okay. I think I'm going very slowly.